Hi everyone, it's Dr. Keenan. You know, a year ago, just about this time, I was driving home at 2 a.m. and I hit a moose. And for those Canadians that are out there watching, you know a moose is a large animal and that many people don't survive when they're one of these things hits you. I was driving, it was so pitch dark, all I knew was that this thick creature was in front of me, and then all of a sudden it was through my windscreen. There was snow on the ground, it was cold outside. I pulled over to the side of the road, I got out of the car, and then I realized that I had hit this creature, but I was there, I was still alive. And you know something, when this happened, it was literally just about the week that lockdown happened. And everybody at that time a year ago, everyone was so afraid of COVID. Everyone was afraid of this disease that was coming, this epidemic, this pandemic that was gonna take over the world. But guess what? I didn't expect that night that my life could have been gone in just a few seconds. And I want you to think about that today. You know, for many of us, we still are living in the fear of COVID through restrictions, through what you hear on the media. Remember, less than 1% of people get admitted to the hospital and less than 1% of those people die. So COVID is a real illness. There is no doubt about that. I truly believe in it. But you have to think about the other illnesses that can affect you on a day-to-day basis. And so don't be overcome by just that fear of this disease that's kind of in our face just at the moment. You know, things like heart attacks are still happening. Things like stroke are still happening. For me, I had no idea or no thoughts in a million years that I would strike a moose that time of the night. But I'm happy to be here a year later to live about it. And the reason I want to come on to talk about that today is a few hours later when I was at the hospital, you know, I woke up and I looked at my phone to look at my messages. What came to me on my phone was a post by Gabrielle Bernstein, and many of you may know her. She's from America, and the post said that serenity is knowing that the universe has your back. And at that moment I thought, hey, wow, you know, it just wasn't my time yet. It wasn't my time to go, because many people had gone when they were hit by a moose in their vehicle in the middle of the night on a cold winter's night. It wasn't my time. So is it your time? But I think we all have to think, today is our time to do and to live in this moment, be in this present moment. That's all that we have. You know, many times, you know, anxiety comes about because we look at the past and we have regret for what we could have done, what we should have done. We think about the future and we have this fear of what's coming up next, what could happen, what if lockdown never ends, what if COVID never goes away. But you know something? Our precious moment is that it is precious. It's the only time that we have right here and right now. So you need to choose how you're gonna use it. Do you want to waste it on regrets of past? Do you want to waste the time on worries about the future? Or do you want to use that time to enjoy every moment that you have today? So enjoy it, live it, appreciate it, no matter where you are. Enjoy the sun, enjoy your kids, enjoy your spouse, enjoy your healthy body, enjoy the fact that you can breathe fresh, clean air wherever you are. So many of you have reached out to me because you've been just feeling overwhelmed during this latest time, and I would hope that you could join me tomorrow. I'm gonna have a special Zoom. I really haven't done one of these before, Sunday morning at 10 a.m. And I'm gonna give you some exercises to do by using your breath to overcome anxiety. You know, by using my breath, it's a tool that I use to ground me every day when I'm at the emergency room before I have to go into a trauma, when I have to see a patient, when I'm gonna go into a different difficult conversation with somebody. So the breath can be an amazing tool. So 10 a.m. tomorrow, the link is gonna be down here on my Facebook page. I hope that you'll join me, and I hope that you find these little times, this time that I can reach out to you, useful. Have a wonderful day.